Hey, it's pretty sunny out, pretty bright, so my glasses are gonna turn dark real quick. Hope you don't mind. Anyway, I noticed something through the week when I was working that was interesting, but I was either way too busy or it was very windy, so we're back here on a Sunday afternoon to take a look at that. Isn't that weird? What that is, that's gonna be the boss's new desk. And of course, it's a piece of something that we had to cut out of something. So let's go look at the something. Okay, we're here on the back lot where we store our junk. You see there's an old power turbine rotor, single stage, single wheel power turbine. You have seen that before. It weighs about half a ton. And right here, you have the engine nacelle from an airliner. I'm not sure which airliner, but we're lucky enough to see inside, somebody's written aircraft 6615 nose cowl upper side. Anyway, this is the air inlet extension on a turbofan airliner. Everything that we see here is in front of the rotor of the engine, and it's quite interesting to see the way it's built. Get in closer, you can see that this is all sound attenuation material, these tiny holes. It's actually much quieter than a reflective surface. Fascinating. All these rivets. Actually, they're like threaded rivets. We're going to take a look inside. A view that I don't think you get to see very often. Even when I was in training to be an engine tech, the AMEs and the structures guys never got to look at the inside of an engine nacelle, because this has been sawed and sliced straight down. It's incredibly strong. Let's see if I can. It's double wall honeycomb aluminum. Well, double wall here and double wall there. So what's that? Quadruple wall. This is a big empty space inside there. But look at the anti-icing feature. And anti-icing is different from de-icing. Anti-icing prevents ice from forming. De-icing dislodges it once it's been formed. This is the forward edge of the engine inlet, right there. And this space here is vented. This space here is pressurized with hot air from compressor discharge. You can see it's sealed with like a silicone all the way along the inside. And these little holes, can you see those holes? Those little holes, they let the air flow out and impinge upon this surface, heating it. So that way, a lot less air is used for anti-ice than would be if we just filled this space with hot air. And the more anti-icing air you use, the more power you take away from the engine. So this is aluminum alloy. Look at those fasteners, those are beautiful, aren't they? This is so well put together, I can't believe it. It's massive. It's incredibly strong, as you'd expect, because air gets sucked in here at about a ton of air per second goes through this engine inlet. Not sure exactly what airliner it's from, but I would guess that the fan diameter is about 8 feet, so it's something like a 767 or an L1011 or a Lockheed TriStar, something like that. So you're looking at the big class of engines, the RB211s, the what are the Pratt & Whitney's called? The 4000s and the GE90s possibly, or the GE's CF6s. But it looks a little bigger than a CF6, doesn't it? This is a very rare opportunity to see an engine inlet cowling sliced open basically in half. Since we're on the subject of anti-icing. Okay, normally when you say compressor discharge air, it's not bled off somewhere along the case. It's fully compressed air. And right there on this industrial engine is where, that's a cover plate blocking off where the anti-icing air would normally come out of. So this is an industrial engine that is rigged up not to use anti-icing air. But of course, there is no such thing as a variable inlet guide vane without passages inside for anti-icing air, they're just not used. And the trailing edge of the variable inlet guide vanes, there's little slots. That's for the exit of anti-icing air. When it's turned on, these are pressurized with compressor discharge air. The air goes in here. First it travels through the struts. When people say, why isn't the fan moving? They're always talking about the struts and the VIGVs, because here is the first stage of the compressor. And as you all know, because I've said it a million times, there is no fan on the J79 or LM1500. Interestingly enough, from a previous project for a different reason, we have a scrapped front frame of a CF6-6. And this thing looks about the size of the air inlet extension we've just looked at, and the air inlet, the cowling, which is actually part of the aircraft, would be extending past, in this particular situation, the bottom, which is the front of this engine. These are the stators for the fan, which also act as struts for the front bearing housing. And the inlet cowling would extend past that and would direct the air into the inlet of the engine. These two parts are not related that I know of. This one's been here for a couple years and it is scrap. It's just so big and heavy we don't really know what to do with it. And there's the inlet cowling over there. I don't know what aircraft it's from. I don't think it was specified. It doesn't really matter for what it's going to be used for. It's going to be used for a desk. Quite interesting. The strangest stuff. And these are compressor cases for LM1500-J79s. Not dash, slash, because it's the same engine. But these are also scrap. There's fasteners and the odd linkage, and there's a filter there that can be reused, but all these parts are, they're no good anymore. And that, believe it or not, is a Wright R3350. A very large and very powerful 3,350 cubic inch piston aircraft engine. Okay, in our junkyard, there's a couple of Arendas there. Old, obsolete ones that are retired and scrapped. But they're handy for pieces like clamps, fittings, fasteners, hardware, that kind of thing that if you don't have them, you have to have them made, so they're very expensive. And if they're on those engines, they're free. So they're handy things to pick from. But look what else I found, since we're on the subject of anti-icing. That thing leaning up against the shelf, the shed shelf, is the tap-in point for the anti-icing system on the combustor outer case. And there's the valve. And there's two of them side by side. There's only one used per aircraft. And it goes down into what I call the antlers. Okay, right behind me is what I call the antlers. I've gone in there and risked cutting myself to pieces because there's all kinds of razor sharp stainless steel edges. But that is an anti-icing manifold for a J79. You can see maybe why I call it the antlers. Very cool. All these connections match up with the front frame and they feed hot air, anti-icing air, from the compressor discharge or from the combustor outer case, into the anti-icing system. All stainless steel, all quite awkward to install. And that's most of it there. There's been a couple things cut off. Okay, we're back in the shop. And there's the 1500 with the port blocked off. Let's take a look over here. To the J79, where that oval port, there'd be another one like that right here on the top of the engine, and it's not there. Because in this engine, the anti-icing air comes from these struts and it goes forward. So the air here has passed behind or into the seal between the compressor and the case and is used as thrust balance air. It pushes against the back of the compressor and then it leaks out this vent. Normally it would be vented overboard, but in here it's captured and used for anti-icing purposes. You might say this is a more efficient design because it uses air that has already done some work versus the most expensive type of air you can get, which is fully compressed compressor discharge air. Very interesting. Anti-icing. I was hoping I could show you on our cutaway model the anti-icing, but it's not installed. We've got the front frame and the struts and the inlets for the anti-icing air at each of the connections, and it's not hooked up, so it's not there. The things you see when you take a walkabout in the back lot, and that's what I'm here for, to take advantage of the unusual opportunities that present themselves when we have parts like this being cut open, salvaged, repaired. This isn't really a repair. It's more of a repurposing of a retired aircraft piece that I thought was very interesting. So from the back lot at SNS Turbines on a Sunday afternoon, thanks for watching.